Growing up, the Carol Burnett Show was required viewing in our home. There were a lot of shows that were off limits for one reason or another, but my father had determined that Carol's brand of comedy was both funny and fairly safe from a content perspective. And you know what? I was okay with that, primarily because of that guy in the middle of this picture right here. Along with Don Knotts, I thought that Tim Conway was one of the funniest guys around. No one, and I mean no one, could play a dim-witted doofus better than Tim. And the rest of the cast was equally as brilliant, led of course by Ms. Burnett herself. Carol is one of those rare comedians who I think has the ability to pull off awkward and elegant at the same time. And like I said, she surrounded herself with an amazing crew. I was always impressed with how hilarious Lyle Waggoner could be. After Carol Burnett, he would take on the role of Major Steve Trevor in the TV version of Wonder Woman, and despite the fact that there really wasn't anything funny at all about that role, he would always make me smile as well. Of course, that whole show made me smile. And Carol would have some amazing guests on her show. Being a huge Batman fan, Frank Gorshin's appearance did not go unnoticed. I also appreciated Cher's guest appearances on the show, for obvious reasons. Her amazing voice and her comedic flair. That's what you thought I was going to say, right? Anyway, Carol also made sure that every season opened with one special guest. Someone she considered to be her lucky charm. Who am I talking about? Well, it's none other than good old Gomer Pyle himself, Mr. Jim Nabors. Every single season, Nabors would be on hand, and he was great. He and Carol would sing, and of course they would goof around a whole lot. Carol and Jim's relationship started before her variety show. It was a friendship that had been built on a tremendous respect that the two of them had for each other's talent. Around the same time as the debut of her show, she would also make an appearance on Neighbors' spin-off from The Andy Griffith Show, Gomer Pyle USMC, where she played the amorous Corporal Carol, who tried to put the moves on good old Gome, threatening his relationship with his girl. Corporal Carol was hilarious, so much so that when she returned in a later episode, she had been promoted to Sergeant Carol, most likely for reasons having to do with being so darn funny. Between her appearances on his show and his appearance on her show to kick things off, Carol made the decision that Neighbors was her good luck charm, and from that point forward, come hell or high water, Neighbors would show up on every season premiere. When Jim Nabors passed away, Carol Burnett said this about him. Jim and I remained close friends for 52 years. He was the godfather of my daughter, Jody. Every year, he was always the first guest on my variety show. I considered him my good luck charm. My heart is heavy, and I'm grateful he was a large part of my life. I miss him. I love him. What an amazing tribute to such an awesome human being.
And even after his passing, Jim continues to open up for Carol. When CBS ran Carol's 50th anniversary program, they led off with a special titled Remembering Jim Nabors. All right, now it's your turn. Please let me know what you think and share your memories in the comments section. And while you're at it, I'd love a thumbs up if you enjoyed this video. And I would be absolutely honored if you would consider subscribing to my channel. I talk about music, movies, and mostly TV from the 50s, 60s, 70s, and 80s. You know, the good stuff. But most importantly, and as always, thank you so much for watching.